Hey everybody, it's Christina from Crafty Paws. I wanted to share with you all my entry for Lisa of Maggiemylow's 1000 Subbie giveaway challenge. She's located in Canada and the challenge goes through September 1st, but she's accepting submissions for the mail-in portion through, I think, September 15th. So you still have time if you kind of hustle through. But I thought her challenge was super interesting and a great idea. The first part of the challenge is to leave a comment in the video that I'm going to link to. The second is to share by video response a project that shares something personal about you. And that's this response for me. I thought I would share three very, very simple layouts that really capture what is most important to me in my life. So the first is a picture from my fourth wedding anniversary. It was before we went out to dinner. My husband took this picture of me and our two fur babies, Biscuit, who's 12, and Bandito, who's 1. And this was a few months after we had gotten him, and I absolutely love the picture. I usually don't like pictures of myself, but with the dogs, I can make an exception. So I think this might be one of the few pictures I've allowed taken of me over the last couple of years. The second layout page, is a picture of my husband napping on the couch with our older dog, Biscuit. And this was before, pre-Bandito. And that just captures what my husband and I like to do on Saturday afternoons. We lead super busy lives in New York City, and naps on Saturday afternoons are cherished and really protected. We try really hard to make sure we can get in a nap, either on a Saturday or a Sunday. And the last layout is my husband napping with the two dogs, or trying to. She's obviously still awake. I don't know if it's obvious to you, but her eyes are open. And my husband has basically collapsed there, passing out. But the little guy is busy as can be, lying on his chest and I think gnawing on an antler. So that captures, you know, continues to capture our growing family and, again, what we like to do. This little caption just says, "Dream a little dream with me." And I used a Martha Stewart punch around the page spider web to kind of capture the idea of dreams and kind of cobwebby thoughts during dreams. I thought I'd take a minute or two also to share my mail-in entry. That portion of her challenge is to create a kind of baseball card, whether a horizontal or a vertical, that tells her about yourself. So what you like in crafting, your YouTube name, and then a handful of things about you, and she has specific things that she wants to know. So the front of my card is basically a picture of me, Crafty Paws, my YouTube channel, hexagons, which I totally love. I don't know, I'm a little obsessed right now. Buttons, and I did blue buttons because that's my favorite color, and a blingy button because I love bling. And then I also added three little heart bling pieces, and then this shows my love of Martha Stewart and EK Success punches. So this is two EK Success scallop circles, and then this is a layered piece of a punch that is a Martha Stewart punch, hugs and kisses. And then lastly, I put in a houndstooth, because I love houndstooth, K, because I spell Christina with a K, and y'all might think that's kind of silly, but I chose my American name when I was about 12, and I specifically chose Christina with a K because I really just love the way that letter looks. It looks, you know, funky and balanced, and I don't know, something about the letter K just appeals to me. So I included that as well, and obviously everything is on a dog-related background paper. The back has answers to her questions, my birthday, my favorite color, which is blue, favorite brands, which is currently Gorgeous Girls and Graphic 45, and then down below is Martha Stewart. She was kind of like how I got into crafting. And then other general likes. I love bling, the sun, glitter, dogs, drinks, and I have little cocktail drinks down there representing that, crafting, and travel, and I have a couple of suitcases representing the travel. She also asked that you put your address, but I've got mine covered here. And I actually also used a mailing label that the local animal shelter that I support had printed out for me. So it also has the logo for the local animal shelter that I really love and support. And that's it. I hope you all participate. This was super fun, and I actually made two of these, one that I could keep for myself. So I don't know. I thought it was a really smart giveaway challenge. And Lisa, thank you so much for inspiring me to create this. And this will be off in the post to you today. Thanks a lot, everybody.